Hot dog, hot dog. Welcome back to the program, everybody. Welcome back. Welcome back. You're just listening to me holding it together. Anyway. What were we doing? Oh. We were talking about Joey Ramone earlier, and, you know, whatever the story was surrounding that guy. We were talking about Pete Davidson and how everyone's all mad that Pete Davidson is playing Joey Ramone. I don't understand why, because, if you look at Pete Davidson's face, you can clearly tell that he's suffering from whatever disease it was that Joey Ramone suffered from, you know. So, you know, I think it's a perfect fit. Someone was like, "Oh, Adam Driver should play Joey Ramone," and you know, that doesn't make any sense because that guy's like giant and muscular and you know, better looking, right? I mean, you know, not that Joey Ramone was a bad looking dude or anything, but he clearly suffered from Pete Davidson syndrome. So, I mean, you get what I'm saying. You can't have a handsome guy, you know, playing Joey. Or just in general, you know, when, like, the character is a Joey-type character, you can't have, like, a better-looking guy, you know? You know what I mean? The Elephant Man, starring George Clooney. I mean, that might work. It might work. He doesn't do wrong. But speaking of frontmen and women, I think this ties into Ant's review tonight, right? Well, whatever. Let's throw it over to Ant. Ant, what do you got for us, Ant?
Hey. Thanks, Bass Amp. Welcome to Ant Reviews Things. Today I'll be reviewing my favorite frontmen in bands. Or is it front person? Bass Amp.
What?
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Wrong answer.
What?
Let's go. Iggy Pop. Good. I will give Mick Jagger some credit. David Bowie. Lemmy. Ozzy. Ian Anderson. He doesn't have a leg to stand on. Prince. Dave Grohl. Freddie Mercury. Boots Electric from the Eagles of Death Metal, and Howlin' Pele from the Hives. Hey, St. Louis, do you want to discuss Axel Rose?
I do.
I didn't think so.
What?
Before I get into it, I want to tell a true story about the best front person I ever got to see. Her name is Kelly. She's the singer of a band called Tiger Sex. She performed while pretty much only wearing her underwear, and she had no regard for her safety or the safety of the people around her. I got really concerned she was gonna hurt herself, and that's when she almost hit me in the head with a microphone stand. I backed up just in time. Kelly is what rock and roll should be. Rock and roll should be sexy and dangerous all at the same time. Oh man! Dee Snider is rolling over in his grave, and he's not gonna take it. All right, Bass Amp.
What?
I got a battle. It's a battle between two of my favorite frontmen of all time. Maybe you can help me settle this. Here we go. Paul Stanley versus David Lee Roth.
David Lee Roth.
The two best frontmen in rock and roll ever.
Why is this even?
Both have great stage banter and are great at making high-pitched noises for no good reason.
No, it's David Lee Roth all the way, all right? I will not stand for this, okay? Paul Stanley, I don't know who told Paul Stanley that he needs to front a rock and roll band, but I'm sure that person's regretting it. Paul Stanley, get out of here. And don't get me started on his soul band. He's got some terrible soul band, and it's just, I never wanted to slap a guy in the mouth while he was singing before, but that's what Paul Stanley makes me want to do with his weird soul band. They look like a Craigslist band. You know what a Craigslist band is? It's a band where no one in the band looks like they should know each other, you know? And this band looks like nobody should know who Paul Stanley is, you know? Like, half of them should be like, you know, they're all in the wrong age demographic, first of all. Like, all of them are probably like, you know, who's Kiss? Who's Paul Stanley? I don't know. I just got hired for this gig. And then the other half are like people who, like, you know, just don't know. They're complete strangers, is what I'm saying. And yeah, Paul Stanley, sorry, I can't get on board. David Lee Roth, all the way, DLR.
Both might be arrogant, pompous, and self-absorbed in real life, but they get the job done on stage. I don't see Sammy Hagar doing jump kicks. So, who gets your vote between Paul Stanley and DLR?
DLR!
Basamp,
DLR.
What's your answer?
DLR, all the way! Why is it...
Wrong answer!
What?
Hey, Basamp! Remember, no matter how high you think you can kick your leg, DLR is 66 years old. Back to you, Basamp! Zimity Bop Bow!
I said DLR. I said David Lee Roth. Paul Stanley. Get out of here. What a jerk. Ugh. Sorry. They put me in a bad mood. And the only thing that'll cheer me up is the theme from the Jackie Gleason show. Whatever. Here's Tiger Sex.
Yeah. this is Kelly from Tiger Sex. Like and subscribe to Ant Reviews Things.